Yes, Walt Disney from the inescapable sounds of Frozen.
Let it go!
Let it go!
Way to go!
To their brand new upcoming superhero movie, Big Hero 6.
Oh no.
The House of Mouse is experiencing something of a renaissance at the moment. And as one of the leaders of Walt Disney Studios for the past 20 years, producer Roy Conli has been a part of all of it.
I've always wanted to know with Disney films, is there like a concerted decision that happens in a room somewhere where they decide we're going to make the audience cry at some point? Like, is somebody just put that down as a mandate?
Well, yeah, I think when you start with the film, you basically have a basic conceit, and once you start developing that conceit, something will happen where you say, okay, this is emotionally where we're going to grab them. We knew from the very beginning that this was going to be a story about a young man who suffers a loss and then is repaired by essentially his brother's invention.
It is all right to cry.
No.
Crying is a natural response to pain.
I'm not crying.
I will scan you for injuries.
Don't scan me.
Scan complete.
Unbelievable.
So there's nobody leaning over a table just going, I'm going to make every child in the world just cry tears of despair. That never happens.
No.
That is actually a little bit disappointing. I like to imagine that was you. You joined Walt Disney at the time they were making The Lion King.
Yeah.
Firstly, thank you for my childhood.
It's
appreciated.
That's good.
That was really the golden period for Disney, and immediately
after
that, it felt like things got harder for Disney.
Absolutely.
What
absolutely.
Happened?
I think what happened is, one, we were trying to duplicate our success or replicate our success. You can't do that. We were telling stories in a way that we were trying to fit it into a formula to a certain degree. And then I also think there was a period where we became very executive driven. And what's happened since 2006, it is a director driven studio. It is a filmmaker driven studio.
In your 20 years or so at Walt Disney, what's been the hardest decision to make?
Oh, wow, that's an interesting question. You know, we make decisions on story every day. We call it the Story Trust, and it is essentially our group of directors, and that group works as a team on every individual's film. And every time we screen, they come in, sit down, they watch the film, and then we sit down and we tear it apart. And we sit down and are incredibly truthful about what's working, what's not working, what do we need to change. And then we go immediately into a rewrite mode, a reboard mode, and then we screen it again in 12 weeks and look at it, and same thing happens. You do that about 9 times through a production.
Is there a film that you have made that you've worked on that you wish had done better, that more people had seen?
Oh yeah, Treasure Planet.
Why?
I think it's a really beautiful movie, and I think, you know, the talent and the world that we created was really spectacular.
I'm fluent in flatula gym, took 2 years of it in high school.
And it just, for some reason, didn't hit.
We jumped out a window.
No, but the quiet. Shh.
Shh, we jumped out a window.
You can't say things like that around Ed Gas.
Shh. Shh.
When you're designing characters like this, you know, it's a big commercial venture as well. Do merchandising get involved at the design stage?
Now, you know, that's the great thing about working at Disney. What they want us to do is make great films. And there's a whole team behind us that come in and do, you know, the video games and the toys.
Harry baby. Harry baby.
But it must, like, occur to you in the back of your head when you're looking at that on the storyboard going, I want to hug that. I know children are going to want to hug that. It must occur to you.
Well, I mean, I think we all have a sense of appeal. You know, that's one of the tenets of Disney Animation, make something appealing. But it's like, we're not chasing down toys. It's great. We don't have to do that because essentially what we're building, someone will identify as, hey, that's going to be great. What we want to do is just tell the great story.